our trip to Sarnath started with the Moolagandha Kuti Vihar. It is open from sunrise to sunset, with a brief closure of the main temple from 11:30 in the morning to 1:30 in the afternoon. The temple was built and maintained by the Mahabodhi Society. The interior of the temple depicts various scenes from Lord Buddha's life. Sarnath is located in the confluence of the river Varuna and the Ganges. The name Sarnath has been derived from the word Saranganath, which means Lord of the Deer. Three of us had hired an auto for 600 rupees from Gadolia, and we visited Sarnath, BHU and the other local temples. In Kartik Purnima, Lord Buddha's Asthi is brought out for public view, and devotees from around the world flock in Moolagandha Kuti Vihar to pay homage. In Sri Lanka's Anuradhapuram, Emperor Ashoka's daughter Sanghamitra planted a twig taken from the Mahabodhi tree of Bodh Gaya. The Sinhalese Buddhist revivalist Angarika Dharmapal, in turn, brought a sapling from the Bodhi tree of Anuradhapuram and planted in Sarnath. The sapling attained its full growth and stands strong in its full glory.
The Mauryan Emperor Ashok had built a stupa in Sarnath to preserve and spread the teachings of Lord Buddha. It was over here in Sarnath that the concept of Buddhist Sangha first came into existence. Thus we can say that Sarnath is an amalgamation of the three ratnas of Buddhism, that is Buddha,
Dhamma and Sangha.
Yeah. After attaining enlightenment in Bodh Gaya, it was here in Sarnath that Lord Buddha delivered his first sermon to five of his former companions. He asked his followers to lead a middle path, that is, neither a life of too much luxury nor an austere one.
Lord Buddha met his first five disciples at the Chokhandi Stupa. It was originally built during the Gupta period and later on modified by Raja Todarmal's son Govardhan to commemorate the visit of the Mughal Emperor Humayun. Sarnath carved out a niche in Greco-Buddhist art. Some of the masterpieces can be found at the Sarnath Museum. The Lion Capital, which is a national emblem, was erected to commemorate Ashoka's visit to Sarnath, is also kept inside the museum. The Chinese Buddhist temple is very welcoming with its bright yellow hues. We spent some quality time under the Chinese lanterns and amidst the greenery. Following the calm and clean alleys, we found two colorful lions guarding the Tibetan Buddhist monastery. The tranquil compound soothes the eyes and heals the mind. Different countries have constructed the Buddhist temples in their typical architectural styles, and Japan is no exception. The Japanese pagoda of Sarnath is a copy of its famous original in Kyoto. The temple houses a sandalwood idol of Lord Buddha depicting the posture of Mahaparinirvan. The giant Buddha statue is bound to catch your attention. Blooming water lilies accompanied us as we moved towards the 80-foot long Buddha statue. It was inaugurated by the Prime Minister of Thailand in 2011. Constructed with an estimated cost of Rs. 2 crore, it is built out of 815 sandstones. It took 14 years to get completed and is a symbol of Indo-Thai friendly ties. The Wat Thai Temple gives a glimpse of mini Thailand through its tapering roof. The quaint little town has so much to offer that the trip of Sarnath acquired a permanent place in our hearts. We will be glad if you enrich us with your valuable travel experiences in the comment section. Stay healthy and keep traveling.